Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we learn how to write a number in scientific notation. Previous videos showed you how to take a number that was already in scientific notation and write it in decimal form, similar to the numbers you see here. So in this video, we show how to write these numbers in scientific notation. All right, in scientific notation, a number is written as the product of two factors. The first factor is a number between 1 and 10, and the other number is the power of 10. So here are some examples where the first number is somewhere between 1 and 10. Like I have 1.51, I've got a 9.09. In other words, the first digit before the decimal point has to be a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9. And you're timesing it by 10 to some exponent. And it could be a positive or a negative number. And in fact, it has to be an integer. It can't be like 10 to the 1/2. Okay, so this is what scientific notation looks like. Now what we're going to do is take a number that's written in standard form. For instance, this, remember, would be 530. This is the number in standard form or decimal form. And how would we write that in scientific notation? So we're going to take the number 530, write it as 5.3 times 10 squared. Or how would we take the number, this would be 8.01 times 10 to the negative 3. If we did that, that will be 0.00801. Because remember, you have to move the decimal 3 places to the left. Okay. And the question is, if I had given you this number, 0.00801, how would you write it in scientific notation? And that's what we're going to be learning how to do in this video. All right, so here are two numbers, and we want to write each number in scientific notation. All right, well, in scientific notation, we know that it has to be a number between 1 and 10 times 10 to some power. All right, so this is what we know. This is going to be something times 10 to some power, and this is going to be something times 10 to some power. Now, what do I put in front of this times 10? Well, what you have to do is look for the first number that's not a zero. So you're starting to the left, and you see a 5, and you say, well, I want the decimal point to be after the 5. So that would be 5 point. Now, underneath it, I'm going to write what that would look like. You could write 5.400, right? If you just put a decimal point here. This is not the same number, keep in mind, right? But you don't need extra zeros past the decimal point. So what we do is we want to rewrite this as just 5.4. Now we've written the number, we've written this as 5.4 times 10 to some exponent, because remember, we want to write 5,400 as 5.4 times 10 to something. Okay? So you don't write those trailing zeros. The question is, how would I get this number? I need to get a bigger number, right? Because 5.4 is a lot smaller than 5,400. So that tells me there's going to have to be a positive number here. So imagine if your decimal point was right here. Okay, it's not really right there. You would have to move it 3 to the right to get the number you really want, right? To get this big number. So that tells you you're going to have to move it 3 to the right. And that's how we write 5,400 or 5,400 in scientific notation. 5.4 times 10 cubed. Okay, so I'm going to give you one to try that's similar to this one. Let's do 312,000. See if you could figure out what that is. Put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Alrighty, so where would the decimal point have to go? It would have to go after the 3. So we have 3.12, and when we have only zeros left, we don't write all those zeros there. Times, remember you're going to multiply by 10 to some exponent. Now, 3.2 is a lot smaller than 312,000, so we're going to have to again multiply it by a 10 to some positive exponent, so we get the large number. And what would that be? Some people just count between here and where the exponent, how many digits are in between here? There's 5. So you could think of it that way, right? So do you see how, like, if the exponent was, I mean, I'm sorry, if the decimal was here as opposed to here, right? So we can get 5 that way. Or you could say, well, how would I, oops, sorry about that. How would I go from 3.112 to this number? And I'd say, well, it's really not here, right? I'd have to go 5 places to the right to see where the real number, 312,000. So that's 10 to the fifth. So we have 3.12 times 10 to the fifth. Okay, let's look at the next one. This is a small number, 0.0814. Again, it's going to be something times 10 to some exponent, right? So the question is, where does the decimal point need to be in scientific notation? So if you read from the left, you find the first digit that's not zero, and that would be the 8, and you want to put the decimal here. So that would be 8.14. Now notice this time there are no extra zeros that you're going to take off, unlike these two problems up here. So I have 8.14. Now that's a lot bigger than 0.0814, right? So we need to get a smaller number for our answer, right? Because the decimal point really is not here, is it? It's all the way over to the left, two spaces to the left. You would have to go to the left two spaces to really have that number, 0.0814. So you're going to the left negative 2. Now, when you look at these, you should, a lot of people get confused. They do it exactly backwards. They'll either write 10 squared when it should be 10 to the negative 2, or they'll write 10 to the negative 5, and they say, how do you remember which one it is? Well, you look at it. This is a small number, right? Less than 1. And this is a small number because you're taking 8.14, you'd have to move it 2 to the left. So let's say you had done it wrong. Okay, what's a common mistake? Someone will do this. They'll say, oops, times, want to write equal 8.14. And they might put 10 squared. That's a common mistake. People do that. But what's 8.14 times 100? Well, it's going to be 814. Hopefully, you could see these are definitely not going to be equal to each other. So you always want to go back and check since now you know how to multiply, right? When you have it, when you're multiplying by 10 to some exponent. All right, so here's one for you to try. 0.0814. So try this one on your own. Put this one in scientific notation. All right, so you want the decimal point to be where? After the 5. So how would you read that? 5.2. So I'm going to put 5.2. And you're going to multiply by 10 to something. And the question is this going to be a negative exponent or a positive exponent? All right. Well, the original number, the real number this stands for, is 0.00052. It's a very small number, much smaller than 5.2, right? So we're going to have to go to the left, right, when we move our decimal point to get it where we want. So I would have to move it how many spaces? 1, 2, 3, 4 to the left to get the actual number. So keep in mind what we're doing. We are saying this is two ways of writing the same number. On the left, this is called the decimal form of the number. Somebody call it the standard form of a number. You hear different things. And this is the number in scientific notation. And you want to be able to go back and forth. If you're given a number in scientific notation, can you write the decimal number? If you're given the decimal number, could you write it in scientific notation? So let's just try a few more. All right, here are four problems for you to try. So put the video on pause and try these on your own first. All right, so let's do them. So we're going to write what these are equal to if written in scientific notation. So for the first one, you have to think where you're going to put the decimal point after the 7. So you have 7.392 times 10. Now, you want to do 7.392 times something so that it equals this big number. So I'm getting a bigger number, so you're going to have to move the decimal how many places? 1, 2, 3 to the right. So I hope you got 7.392 times 10 cubed. All right, let's do the next one. 56,000. Right, again, you're going to have to put the decimal point after the 5, but remember we don't write all those extra zeros after the 6. So 5.6 times 10, and we're trying to get a bigger number, right? Bigger than 5.6, so it's going to be a positive number again. And if the decimal point was before the 6, to get it over here at the end where the decimal really is, you'd have to move 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. So that's 5.6 times 10 to the 4th. Next one. We want to put the decimal point after the 8. So we write 8.19. And 8.19 is bigger than this little tiny number, 0.00819. So we know it's going to be a negative exponent. So the question is, how far to the left do I have to go? The decimal point was after the 8. 1, 2, 3 spots to the left. Negative 3. And the last one. You want to put the decimal point after the 6. Well, there is nothing after the 6. So you could write 6 or you could write 6.0. Okay? Sometimes people write it as 6.0 to show, yeah, it looks more like scientific notation. And this will be times 10. Again, this is a very tiny number, so it's going to be to some negative number for the exponent. And how many places would you have to go if the decimal was after the 6? You'd have to go over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the left. And there's our answer. Either way is correct. So here are some examples writing numbers in scientific notation. And just to practice, let's write something in scientific notation as a decimal number, right? In fact, that's how you could check any of these. Let's take this 8.19 times 10 to the negative 3. And see what it equals. What would you do? You would move the decimal 3 to the left. So that should give you 0.00819. And of course, that's how you could check that answer. So you want to be able to go back and forth. That's how you check your answer. Go ahead and do this computation here, and it better end up right where you want it. Okay, so that's how to do scientific notation. On the next video, we'll work with multiplying and dividing more than one number using scientific notation. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.